Hello.
Welcome to a new video. Today we want to look at the topic of diagnostic ECG, or 12-lead ECG. Before we look at it in practice, however, we would like to clarify a few basics.
The diagnostic ECG, or 12-lead ECG, is used to detect heart disease or arrhythmias. Six extremity leads according to Goldberger and Eindhoven, and six chest wall leads according to Wilson, are routinely derived. If your corpuls3 has the license for the ECG max option, you can also record the right precordial and posterior leads, as well as calculate the three vector loops and the CEB.
We want to show you how to set up a diagnostic ECG and have already prepared the patient accordingly. The upper body is completely undressed and in a slightly elevated position. The chest is also completely dry and clean, and there is no need to shave it. When doing a diagnostic ECG, it is important to ensure that the electrodes for the extremity leads are attached to the extremities. They should be as distal as possible and not on bones. The electrode should only be removed from the packaging immediately before being attached to the patient. You should make sure that they are not dry, that the packaging was properly sealed and is properly sealed again afterwards, and that the manufacturer's instructions regarding the use-by date are followed once the packaging is opened. To ensure reproducibility of the ECG, it is important to make sure that the chest wall lead electrodes are correctly positioned. The same applies here, not directly on the bone, but on the intercostal spaces. And if you use ECG Max, you should pay particular attention to correctly positioning the electrode for V2.
To start recording the diagnostic ECG, press the DECG button. The device will create a preview of the last 10 seconds at a sweep speed of 6.25 millimeters per second. All the leads are shown here. We can check again for possible artifacts or, for example, loose ECG electrodes.
If you still see a wandering baseline, we recommend that you wait a moment until the conductivity of the ECG electrodes on the skin has improved. Otherwise, you can now press start. The ECG is frozen at this point, and the last 10 seconds are saved for interpretation. At the same time, the patient data input screen opens. If your corpuls3 has a card reader and you have already read the card, or everything has already been read into a connected electronic patient documentation system, this data will be pre-filled. Otherwise, for a correct interpretation with the Glasgow algorithm, you must enter the patient's gender and age. Otherwise, the default is a 50-year-old male patient. In this case, this is a male patient, age 37. I can now confirm everything again with OK. Now the ECG will be measured. The patient can still be monitored during this time, as the vital parameters are still displayed up here in real time. Once the diagnostic ECG has been measured, I can print it out here and then use this printout to make a diagnosis.
Some selected pathologies are already detected during the measurement phase and are displayed using a visual and audio alarm. In addition to a predefined printout, there is now also the option of selecting what you want to be displayed in the printout under the settings option. You now have the option of sending your ECG to any destination address. Here you can use the send soft key to call up your phone book, where you can now select an address. You can then decide whether you want to acquire another ECG or return to normal monitoring mode by selecting cancel.
We will now take a look at the printout we have created with all its components. On the far left, we have the mission data and the patient's vital parameters. This is followed by the Glasgow basic interpretation and the analysis result by the algorithm. It is important that this only serves as an aid and does not replace the complete interpretation of the ECG for us. This is followed by the extremity leads and the chest wall leads. This is followed by the representative beat. This is a graphical representation of the average value of several QRS complexes. Finally, you will also find the complete Glasgow measurement table. If you want to learn more about the topic of Glasgow, we have summarised it in a short and concise white paper. You can find the link to it below in the show notes. Ben, to finish, I would suggest that we summarise the most important points that are necessary for us to be able to make the best possible ECG diagnosis.
Yes, the ECG electrodes must be in perfect condition and correctly placed. And the final diagnosis can only be made based on the printout.
In order to keep artifacts to a minimum, it's important that the patient is in a relaxed position and not in a moving rescue vehicle. Electrical interference should also be minimised as much as possible. We hope you're able to take some information away with you. Leave any questions or suggestions down in the comments. And as always, feel free to subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss anything. Goodbye, until next time.
Ciao.